Hello students, good morning to everyone. Today I am here to take your moral science class for class 3rd. We will start with the first chapter. The name of the chapter is God is Love. Here I have written God is Love. Here one story is given that we will read and understand, and we will understand the meaning of this chapter, God is Love. Once a king called upon his counselors and ministers together. Do you know why? Here it's given that a kingdom was there. The king. What he did? He called his counselors. Counselors means the persons for giving suggestions in a king's court. And ministers together. Ministers means they are seeing different authorities. They have powers to see the different sectors, different areas. He called them together. And it is asked, do you know why? For what reason did he call? They had to give a name to God. Which task was given to them? To name the God. What is the name of God? All started thinking. What they started doing? They started to think that what name can be given to the God. One of the ministers bowed down and told the king. Means what was the practice earlier? Before the king, if you want to speak something, we have to bow down like this. In order to show him respect. Then he did that and told the king, "Oh Lord, my king, I think that God is the source of all knowledge." He gave one name that he told that we can call God as a source of all the knowledge, which all the knowledge in this world comes from the God itself. So we can say that God is the source of all knowledge. So shall we call him eternal wisdom? What you know? Eternal. What is meaning of this word eternal? Eternal means everlasting. Everlasting means which never ends. Which never ends, which never finishes. Eternal means which never ends. So can we call him the eternal wisdom or the wisdom which never ends? Someone else said, God is eternal goodness. What he told? God is eternal goodness. Goodness. No, he must be called the Almighty, argued another. And then the minister told that he must be called for Almighty. In our space, we say, you know, Almighty God, like it, Almighty. God is present everywhere, so he is omnipresent. But our ministers gave him a omnipresent. Why omnipresent? Omni means this word is everywhere. Omni means everywhere. So since God is present everywhere, so we can say him that omnipresent. Omni means everywhere. So we can say him that God is present everywhere. So we can call him omnipresent. Another minister stood. Though all suggested names reflect God's nature, the king was not happy. Whatever the name was given to the God by different ministers or counselors was just showing the nature of the God. But king was not happy with those names. Then the oldest minister in that group, he stood up and he said, how will it be if we call God love? If we call God as love, how will it be? How will it sound? How will it look? They all like the name, and they, what they do? They started clapping together and they said, yes, love is the name of God. Love is the best name or beautiful name which can be given to God. The king gave so many gifts to this old minister. God is love. The flowers and the trees, the birds and the butterflies, the rivers and the oceans, the garden and the woods. These are all gifts of the God itself. The Holy Bible says, God is love. In our school also we do a prayer, no? God still loves the world. We sing a prayer, no? This. Or God's love is so wonderful. Two prayers are there. That prayers also have the same meaning, that God is love. He has given us so many wonderful gifts like flowers, trees, birds, butterflies, rivers, oceans, then the woods, our parents. These are all gifts of the God. God created us in his own image and likeness. He has given us many talents and abilities like the ability to study. We are able to study. So many persons are there. We are lucky enough to study. So many persons are there who do not get the enough things or study materials. Somehow they are deprived of their rights. Study, play, sing, dance, stand, smile, walk and love. Means we human beings are capable of studying and painting, dancing, singing, reading, writing, thinking, playing, talking. These all things human beings can do, and these are gifts of God. He gave us good parents, brothers and sisters, friends and everything. These all things are given by the God. He also gave us good teachers to teach and good friends to play and enjoy. They are all the symbols of God's love. As it is said that God created us in his own image, so God is love. That's why all the things are symbols of the God's love. Let's love God in return for his love. As God is loving us, so in the same way we should love the God. How can we say that we love God? Joining our hands and by closing our eyes. Let's say, join hands and close the eyes and let's say, oh dear God, I love you. What we have to say? We have to say, oh dear God, I love you. There are many great people in the world who could experience God's love. We will study about a young boy who loved God very much. His name was Kuriakos. He was born in Kerala on February 10, 1805. On the February 10, 1805, he was born in Kerala. His mother was a pious woman. What is the meaning of pious woman? A woman which never does any sins, means not doing bad to others, doing only good things, always praying. Okay, that person is very pious. She taught baby Kuriakos how to love God. She used to pray to God every morning and night. As this child grew up along with his mother, he too learned to love to God and pray to him. He started loving God and praying to him. He loved God very much. He considered God as his dad. He loved God as he loved his own dad. And what he prayed, you are my father, in you I live, in you I do, and in you I work, and in you. So, what we have to remember that God is love, and we have to love the nature's beauty or the everything which is present around us, either the human beings or the animals or the flowers or living things or non-living things. We have to love each and everything just like we are loving God. Then only in return we can say that we are loving the God. Some persons are there, no? What they mean? the dogs, beat the cats. They will, what they will do? They will catch the birds and put in the case. This is not good. Okay, this all things are not good. We should love the animals, birds, flowers, everything in the same way as we are loving God. Because these are all the symbols of the God's love. Okay? We must value each and every object which is present in this world. For today, this much is enough. This chapter, when it's over, exercise of this you will get in the form of PDF. And then you know where you have to do the exercise? Don't make the copy for this. You have to write in the book itself. See, on the page number 7, 3 questions are given. And this page is also given, no, here. What was the name given to God by the oldest minister? Very easy, and second, love. Do you believe in God's love towards you? What you have to write? Yes. Write any 4 loving gifts God has given you. Brother, sister, friends, then teachers. Oh well, no? Then the talents that God gave me. All these 3 given, 7 more we have to write. That I will send. Okay, I will send in the form of PDF. Ability to read, ability to think, ability to walk. Then what you have to write? Ability to study. Then ability to dance, ability to sing, ability to play, ability to love each other, ability to talk to each other, ability to climb up and down. There are so many things, no, we can write. I will send in the form of PDF this exercise. For today, this much is enough. Next day, we will continue with the next chapter. Thank you, class.